Hey everybody, this is the 20 gallon tank I have set up for my wife, and I've got a couple of angelfish in here finally that are really doing well. It took me a while to get a couple of angelfish to establish in this tank, even one angelfish to establish in this tank. So you can kind of see them in the back corner there. I just fed the tank and they're back there feeding from the surface. I was kind of hoping the food would make its way down into the water column a little better so we could see the fish's colors a little more, but they'll start swimming around in a minute hopefully. No real point in this video, just an update on the tank. Not a lot going on. I really do need to get in and do a little bit of maintenance on it. It's due for a water change, and if you will see what looks like a network of plants in there, that is this water sprite. Just grows like crazy. That's the big main mother plant, and then all these little smaller plants you can see have all been sprung off of that main plant there, and all of those little central root bodies are whole new plants. I've also got a ton of snails in this tank. I put them in here by accident. I introduced them when I put some of the plants in there. So that is a warning. If you do buy any aquatic plants from me, and I do just about always have water sprite and stuff like that for sale, I try not to get snails on them, but there's certainly no guarantee. You're not going to get a bag full of snails, but there's, you know, you're not going to get snail-free plants if you are interested in getting any plants from me. So if you are, check my Gmail down in the description below. Otherwise, not really anything to speak of going on in here. We haven't lost any fish. I haven't added any new fish. I've got some guys here doing some tree work over the last few days, and it's really thrown my normal schedule out of whack. I've barely done anything in the fish room. I've had just about enough time to stick a camera in the tank while I'm feeding some of the tanks, and I can get a few, you know, tank cam videos done. And that's about all I've really had time for. And this one I'm trying to shoot while I thought they were taking a break, but it sounds like they're running the bobcat up and down the driveway again, hauling the logs out. So hopefully tonight they're going to get finished up, maybe the next day or two, I don't know. In the meantime, all we're really going to get is some of these short videos that don't have a whole lot of point to them. Again, I haven't had time to sit down and really think about any kind of serious topics about videos, let alone... I love it when the corys dart up to the top like that to get a gulp of air. If you're not familiar with Corydoras catfish or cory cats, that's perfectly normal behavior. If you see yours doing that, that's completely normal. They all do that. They're just swooshing up there to get a gulp of air and then swimming back down to the bottom. So perfectly normal behavior if you see your cory dash to the surface like that. And on that note, keep, you know, make sure there's some surface for them to dash to. If you've got the, you know, glass sitting right at the edge of the water and you've got a cory cat, they will smack into that glass pretty hard when they go up for air like that. So keep that in mind. Other than that, I really can't think of anything else going on. I did get some video of them actually felling the main bole of the tree, the main trunk of the tree. And that was some pretty exciting video. And the really exciting part happened after the video. I've just gotten so used to shooting video over the years that I'm always worried about getting the shot. And I try not to. I wonder what that little spot on this angelfish is right in front of its dorsal fin. It looked like a missing scale when I first looked at it. And now it actually looks like it might be a little something on the fish. So I'll have to keep my eye on that. I don't come in here and look at this tank very often. So this is a good way for me to actually get a little bit of a look at it myself. I can't tell whether that's just a little scale knocked off or that's actually some sort of growth or injury or something. I think it's just a scale knocked off. So as I was filming, right as the trunk was getting ready to fall, I could see it getting, you know, leaning and cracking, and a fly was buzzing around my face, and I just ignored it as best I could. You know, got to get that shot, just got to keep on, you know, filming. And I am not kidding, the stuff out of nightmares, the fly landed on my ear and crawled in my ear. Like all the way in my ear. So at that point in the video, the camera went wild as I started flailing about trying to get this thing, because I didn't know what it was either at this point. I just knew something big just crawled in my ear. And so I ran in the house, and it was scrabbling around trying to figure out how to get back out. Of course, it couldn't turn around, and it kept trying to flap its wings, and it couldn't flap its wings because it was stuck in my ear canal. And it was freaking out, and I was freaking out, and everybody's freaking out. So I got it. I don't recommend doing this, but I wound up cutting the head off of a Q-tip. So I just had the actual stick part, and I just started sort of trying to go in behind it and dig it out. And eventually I worked it around. I could feel it turn itself around and scrape up against my eardrum. It was really, really loud. And then I could feel it sort of working its way and crawling its way back out. And I got the thing behind it and scooped it out. And I think it lost a wing in there somewhere. So I'm going to have to keep an eye on my ear, if that makes any sense. And, you know, make sure I don't get any kind of infection or something, because I've got fly pieces left behind in my ear or whatever. So that was the exciting bit of my day, watching a tree fall down and then having a creepy crawly crawl into my ear. Ugh, this is the stuff of nightmares. Anyway, on that horrible, awful note, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this video up and say there's a look at my wife's tank. So I hope you enjoyed that, and hope you enjoyed my little horror story there, because that was one worth sharing. Never had that happen before, and I hope I never have it happen again. So anyway, thanks for watching. Make sure you're subscribed. That way you don't miss anything, and you never know what kind of stories you're going to get from me. Don't forget, this one here is my wife's tank. Thanks again, and I will see you real soon on the next one.